morning, students. In last video, we are discussing about different topologies. We will continue with topology. This next topology is tree topology. The tree topology uses two or more bus and star networks connected together. The hub or switch box of star network are connected to a main bus. Thus, a tree network is a bus network of star networks. Its advantage is, first, it is easy to detect the faulty device. It means we can easily detect which computer is out of network or some network cable damaged. Which computer we can easily detect it. Next one, it is easy to expand a network. It means we can easily add some other star networks to this type of topology. The disadvantage is if the common cable line breaks, the entire segment goes down. It means all the networks are disconnected from each other. It is more difficult to configure as compared to other topology. It means the establishment of this type of network is much hard to establish this type of network. Only those people who have the knowledge of the networking, they can only establish this type of network. Next one is star topology. In the star topology, there is a hub or switch box to which all workstations are directly connected. In this way, every workstation is indirectly connected to other through the hub. The hub or switch box is a common connection point between the nodes and peripherals. Notice it means computers. Now this is a figure of star network. The advantage is the computer in this type of topology, computers can be connected easily because just we have to put the plug in the cables in computer and first one end at the in the computer and second end in the switch box. Second one, data transfer between nodes is fast because it is directly connected with switch. Second one, fault can be detected easily. It means because the single computer is connected to that switch, so we can easily detect which computer is not working properly in the network, or which is not connected with network. And if you want to remove any computer, see, very easy, we need to just remove, pull out the cable from that computer, and then that computer now is not a part of that network. Next, my disadvantage is, in the topology, the cable length is very high in compared to other topologies. Because for each nodes or computer, we have to provide the separate cable for each computer. If the central communication point fail, the nodes attached to it are disabled. It means if a switch or hub is not working, then all the computers in this network can't be communicate with each other. Next one, ring topology. In the ring topology, every device has exactly two neighbors for communication purpose. All messages travel through a ring in the same direction, either clockwise or anti-clockwise. Its advantage is data transfer is faster as the cable is connected between two computers. And disadvantage is a failure in cable or device breaks the loop or slows down the entire network. So the yes, so advantage and disadvantages. Next, so these are some topologies that we can use in networking. Now, next topic is client-server network architecture. In this network architecture, there is a main computer known as a server, and other computers are called clients or workstations. A server controls the hardware, software and disk drive and provides other services to clients. Client computers request services, for example, data retrieval and storage, devices and processing power from the server. Client-server architecture is sometimes called two-tier architecture. Now, let's discuss about the networking devices. First one, modem. Modem takes its name from the word modulator, demodulator, which is actually a device and used for conversion of data signals. It enables a computer to receive and transmit data over the network. Computer information is stored digitally, whereas information transmitted over telephone lines in the form of analog signal. A modem converts between these two forms. First one, modulation. Conversion of digital signal to analog, that's a modulation, and demodulation, conversion of analog signal to digital data. And this is a figure of modem. Next one, hub. A hub is a simple device that connects cable from computers on the network together. Hub is not intelligent enough to decide which data packet is meant for which computer. They are useful in connecting more computers to network. Figure of hub. Next one, bridge. A bridge connects two networks working on the same protocol. It is little intelligent than hub in that it can identify computers on the network through their machine addresses. And this is the figure of hub, bridge. Next one, switch. A switch is like an advanced bridge which supports heavy data traffic and higher performance. It checks data packets passing through it and does not let those data packets pass through which have error in them. Next one, routers. Routers connect multiple networks and efficiently handle data transfers among them. It routes data packets based on IP addresses. It connects LAN and WANs together. Next one, gateway. A gateway connects two networks together that may work on different protocols. They take data from one system, interpret it and transfer it to another system. Gateways are also called protocol converters. Gateways are generally more complex than switch or router in their functioning. Next one, routers. It is also known as bridging router. It combines features of both bridge and router. Working as a router, it is capable of routing packets across networks and working at bridge. It is capable of filtering data packets with errors. Now, next topic is cloud computing. The technology that allows access to software, storage devices, server, and other services and infrastructure over internet is called cloud computing. Service providers of cloud computing own powerful servers, storage devices, networking equipments, software and other services which businesses that can subscribe to and pay on usage basis. For example, if my business needs to use a database application, then instead of purchasing it, I can subscribe for database application online from cloud and use it. All the data will be saved on storage servers, and I can work with my data through browser interface. Some top cloud computing service providers and their cloud platforms are Microsoft Azure, Amazon Web Services, Google Cloud Platform, Alibaba Cloud, Oracle Cloud, Apple Cloud, etc. These are the logos of different cloud services. Now, next advantages of cloud. First one, businesses need not to install software and hardware infrastructure completely. Businesses need to pay only for usage of the services subscribed. Businesses save their cost of owning and maintaining infrastructure for their hardware and software needs. Businesses can interact with each other easily over cloud. Some information over cloud can be accessed and shared securely with others. Cloud access provides ease of working from anywhere, anytime, and mostly any device. Businesses need not to worry about the data loss and physical registers, as cloud contains powerful and reliable auto backup facility which begins working in case of disaster. No need to worry about malware threats and software updates. Cloud computing is economical for startup business and help them save costs. Cloud computing is environment friendly as it cuts down the amount of e-waste and energy consumption. So these are some advantages of cloud computing. So that's all for today. In next video, we'll discuss about the types of cloud and cloud computing services and some applications. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.